Gospel according to Mark. The beginning of the Gospel of Jesus Christ, the Son of God. As it is written in Isaiah the prophet, "Behold, I am sending my messenger ahead of you. He will prepare your way. A voice of one crying out in the desert, 'Prepare the way of the Lord, make straight his paths.'" John the Baptist appeared in the desert, proclaiming a baptism of repentance for the forgiveness of sins. The people of the whole Judean countryside and all the inhabitants of Jerusalem were going out to him and were being baptized by him in the Jordan River as they acknowledged their sins. John was clothed in camel's hair, with a leather belt around his waist. He fed on locusts and wild honey. And this is what he proclaimed: "One mightier than I is coming after me. I am not worthy to stoop and loosen the thongs of his sandals. I have baptized you with water. He will baptize you with the Holy Spirit." This time of the year, it's all about getting ready. It's all about preparing. Practically, if you notice, every conversation that you have lately almost inevitably gets around to, "Are you ready? Are you prepared?" And you really think about it. I mean, how many times do we eventually get around to checking up on each other to see who's ahead on their list? Gosh, when you think about it, have you mailed your Christmas card yet? I've already gotten a few in the mail, which means I am in trouble. Have you got all your decorations and lights up yet? I mean, what are you waiting for? The weather is, this is Hazleton, it's gonna snow. Have you got your tree? Have you done your shopping? There are a few of us who did all their shopping back in September. We don't like that. Have you got all of your baking and cooking? Those of you who are bakers and cookers and who have been doing it for the last three generations. I mean, you put all of this together and there is just an unending list of things that you need to do to be ready. And if you don't, you feel guilty. Now, on the other hand, there are people who, for lots of reasons, just don't get into it. And they feel guilty, too. Oh, maybe they just don't have a lot of people left at home to celebrate with. Maybe things just haven't lent themselves to, you know, that holly jolly spirit that keeps blasting out of all of the radios. And as long as you walk through the mall and as you go to your doctor's appointments, and yet you feel bad. You're supposed to be doing something. You want to, you feel it. All the rest of the world is running like mad to get ready for December 25th, which, by the way, always comes at the same time every year. Even though it always seems like suddenly it's here. Are you ready? Are you prepared? It was very interesting. On Thursday, we had a holy hour with our children, the children of our faith formation program, and we had a really wonderful turnout. We had a couple of hundred kids here all praying before Jesus in the Blessed Sacrament. And at the end, as everyone was going away, there was one little girl and her sister. I was saying hello and, of course, asking the inevitable question, "Are you ready for Christmas?"
And one girl looks at me, she goes, "We're only doing stockings this year." Well, the reason was because they just didn't like Disneyland, so they needed to make an adjustment somewhere. But she looks at me, with a typical teenage look, "We're only doing stockings this year. That's the end of the world." And I was trying to console her, trying to remind her that, gosh, maybe you can focus on, who knows what, Jesus for Christmas, that you can maybe not worry so much about all the presents and everything that we seem to think or what it's really all about. And her sister was listening to all of this, turns to me, she goes, she asked a very good question. "Why is it that we give presents anyways to each other?" "Because isn't it Jesus' birthday?" I think she hit on something there. If it is Jesus' birthday, shouldn't he be getting the presents and not each other? What are we preparing for? In the Holy Word of God, it does not say, "Prepare for Christmas." It doesn't say that. Among all the commandments that God gives us, He does not say, "Thou shalt save the economy of the United States by spending lots of money at the end of the year." He doesn't say that. It says, "Prepare the way of the Lord." Prepare the way of the Lord. That is what He wants us to be ready for. That is the reason we do all the rest. Oh, it's great to take a break in the end of the year, the middle of the winter season, to have a holiday. We know that the only reason we do this is because God did an incredible deed. He came down from heaven. And every year, we remember what He has done so that we can also continue to look forward to what He will still do and that He will come again. God is not done yet. And you think Christmas is something worth celebrating? Wait until He comes again. That's going to be something. In the meantime, we keep looking forward by celebrating, preparing the way of the Lord. The church, in its holy gospel, asks us to focus particularly upon John the Baptist, who was so focused upon the coming of the Lord that he hardly even had time to think about eating and drinking. I love that passage about eating locusts and wild honey. Now, maybe if you are an elf nut, you're into that kind of thing today. You can probably go to a store and buy some strange combination of grasshoppers dipped in honey, and it's probably good for you. I'm thinking that John the Baptist only did it because he could not care less what he ate, because he was so filled with looking forward to the Lord. But we are oblates of St. Joseph, the priest who served you here at this parish. And we have another special insight. We have St. Joseph. Because he was part of this too. Prepare the way of the Lord. That came to him in a big way. And Joseph, of everybody, knew what this was all about. The most important thing for him was that child who was coming from God should be welcomed and welcomed well into the world. And there was nothing that mattered except that child. And I'm sure he worked hard to make everything as beautiful and as perfect as he could. But Joseph is also the first Christmas disaster.
Get ready, Christmas disaster. Tree tips over, something catches on fire, we forgot to put the sugar in the brownies. You ever had a Christmas disaster? People thought they were coming, they didn't show up, they had a whole table full of food. It snowed, nobody could get here.
That never happens.
The first Christmas disaster was Jesus' birth. Did Joseph, with all of his careful attention, his love, his hard work, making sure everything was ready, suddenly he has to go to Bethlehem? Did you ever think what that meant? To have to literally leave your home, everything that you had, right? You know, the moment before, you were beloved one is about to bring forth a Savior, this child, into the world, to leave home and go to Bethlehem.
Disaster happens,
big time. But now here is where you see Joseph shine. His only goal was to welcome that child, to be where Jesus was, to do what Jesus needed, and anything else. Anything else that was not part of that gets left behind without regret. Joseph gets to Bethlehem and finds nothing, not even a room. He ends up having to go to a stable. And the warmth that greeted the Son of Man was the warmth of the animals as they breathed upon him. Some Christmas. And yet it was the greatest of all Christmases. Because it was Christ, and nothing could take away from that. Nothing else was necessary. Nothing else mattered. If they go without lots of things, there was no tinsel, there was no music, there were no lights, there were no presents.
Friends, I am not saying that you should go and take down your lights, take back your turkeys, take back your gifts. The economy of the country would collapse if you did that.
And these are beautiful things. They are. If they are done well, for the right reason. We are pulled in so many ways to think that it's really only about brief moment of excitement that comes by giving each other lots of expensive stuff. And it mostly leaves us all feeling faintly disappointed, as if there were supposed to be something more. There is. Jesus, light your lights, give your gifts, sing your songs, eat the food. But celebrate Jesus Christ. Make sure you prepare for him on Christmas. Then it will be a real celebration.